Aloha. Thank you very much for watching this YouTube video. It's been a while since I updated the last two videos, and this is part 6 of the lecture on Ichimaki Shono, or One Sheet Document. Nowadays, I often dream that I'm preaching, you know, Dharma talk in my sleep. And I think this is because I always think Buddhism, and the day and night, and even sleeping without, you know, consciousness, I dream that I'm preaching. And this is very good for me because I like talking about Buddhism. And this is the very reason I'm making this video. Because I'm very happy talking about Buddhism. And I want to share this happiness with as many people as possible. If, you know, so I actually don't care the numbers. Of course, the more people, the better. But I'm not sticking to one, you know, many people. If you, maybe one, listen to and get something, I'm very happy. So thank you very much for your time. So I don't want to waste your time. So I dream, you know, I'm preaching, and this is good, but this is bad for my family, because according to my son, that my sleep talk is long and always very loud, and sometimes talking very long time. And this is actually very interesting, because my language was in English. So I talk, you know, in my sleep in English. And this made me feel that, oh, I finally got it. Because before I came to Hawaii, I was told, my father said that, you know, if, you know, you can talk in your sleep in English, your sleep talk is English, then your English must be good. So now, after so many years, I think, you know, in English, and I speak in English, and I write in English, I listen to in English, and then I sleep in English. So always thinking English. Of course, when I speak, you know, to my son, with my wife, I speak in Japanese, but when I think, English is very good. Although my pronunciation is still not good, but I hope you understand, you know, what I'm talking. And anyway, but I'm very glad that even when I'm sleeping, you know, I'm preaching Dharma talk in English. And I think this may be, you know, if my sermon is very interesting, or, you know, Dharma talk is interesting, is because maybe I practice when I'm sleeping. So anyway, thank you very much. So for me, to be happy, or, you know, being happy is very important. Because if I cannot be happy, if I'm not happy, I cannot talk. Because Buddhism gave me, you know, such inspiration, encouragement, and everything. And knowledge, and not only knowledge, but also wisdom, the most important part Buddhism gave me. However, this life is actually is not always happy, always suffering surround us. So Shakyamuni Buddha started to realize the suffering first. So realization of the suffering is starting point of Buddhism. So we tend to think life could be, you know, happy, and you know, could be filled with many pleasures. However, if we are deeply mindful of this world, you know, surrounding us, this world is not always be happy, not always peaceful. It's always suffering, and this is the very starting point of suffering. However, Buddhism is not, you know, telling this is suffering, but also how to get out from the suffering, how to transcend that suffering, how to change, you know, the situation of suffering to happy one. So this is actually the realization of life in positive way and in better way, is what Shakyamuni Buddha wanted to tell us. About a year ago, February 15th, 2013, was actually very interesting events happened. So one event was actually predicted 1 year ago, like February 2012, by Spanish scientists. they found that, you know, small near-Earth object, near-Earth asteroid was coming to Earth, and they predicted that it might hit the Earth. And this became very news, because even though the near-Earth asteroid is not so big, not so huge, and diameter is about 100 feet, it's about 30 to 40 meters, so it's not so big. Actually, it's very tiny as compared to the vast universe, right? It's very, very tiny, because only 100 feet, you know, from the, you know, unlimited, you know, vast universe. So they found it, and they calculated that they come to the Earth, and they might hit. And although the 100 feet diameter is actually, if hit the Earth, it impacts a lot, it damages a lot, like maybe Kauai will be gone, we don't know, but that's, you know, very dangerous. So later, many scientists calculated, recalculated again, and they found that, you know, it would not hit the Earth. However, it would pass very close, very near to the Earth. That was on February 15th, 2013. So this is called, the asteroid is called DA14, and the formal name is, I think, 2012 DA14. So 2012 DA14 was passing the Earth on February 15th. That was, you know, according to the scientist's calculation, and I really paid that attention. I think I knew, you know, maybe 6 months ago, and then I paid attention, oh, February 15th. And the next day, actually, February 16th, our sister temple, Kappa Jodo, had centennial. Oh, it's very close, you know, if it hit us, or that may be trouble, you know. So I really paid attention. And then February 15th came. And actually, on that day, I was invited, you know, to dinner. And I really forget, and this is good, because if, you know, I paid attention on that day, you know, I have to worry, oh, it might hit, scary, you know. But it was actually, I forgot, so it's okay. But later, I realized, oh, you know, it didn't hit. And I realized that this technology is very advanced. You know, even such a small piece of rock they found. And then, you know, they calculated it wouldn't hit the Earth, and it would exactly the same day it came. And I amazed. And that was one event, a memorable event for me. And another event was that actually on the same day, the not different, no, I mean not same asteroid, but meteorite, the small piece of rock, you know, fell into the Russia. That was really amazed me. I'm glad actually no one died because of the meteoroid. But actually it damaged a lot. And this meteoroid was actually captured by many people in Russia. So it became the big news on that day. And it really amazed me that it comes all of a sudden without any notice. It could happen. And actually, this fact is because we don't know. And because this Earth consists of, you know, so many percent of water, like ocean. So 70% is ocean. So we don't know if, you know, it really fell into or not, because that's such small piece. And meteoroid that fell into Russia is about 17 meter, not big, though. But although this made me realize that, you know, although we have such an advanced technology, however, we cannot predict, we cannot find such a small piece. And how it damaged, we know because of many YouTube videos. You know, it fell Russia and it exploded, and it tremendous damage. If it comes to, you know, the area you live in, what happened? So it might happen because of such a mystery of universe. So this means that from the viewpoint of universe, anything could happen. And because so many stars, so many planets, so many countless asteroids are, you know, floating in the universe, it is no mystery that you know, it come to us anytime. So also we think, we assume tomorrow is peaceful day, tomorrow is happy day. But if we are deeply mindful of the universe, what is the situation happening in the universe? It's not sure. We are not sure. We cannot say tomorrow is peaceful. And misfortune, accidents are actually happening all the time without any notice. So this is life. And Shakyamuni Buddha realized that this is life. This is suffering. So what, you know, we can do if we realize that, you know, this may be the last moment, what we can do? Actually, we have very limited things that we can only enjoy this moment. We can cherish the moment. We appreciate the moment. This is a miracle moment. So to cherish this precious moment, to appreciate that precious moment, is that we can do. So this is the teaching of Buddhism. Okay, life is fragile. Nothing is permanent. Anything could happen without notice right now. But if we are having peaceful, we need to cherish the moment. We need to appreciate the moment. So this is a miracle. And if you are having such a miracle, if we are having such a, you know, happiness, we need to share. We help others. That is, I think, the teaching of Buddhism. And teaching of Buddhism is, you know, of course, this is religion. I think the word religion explains Christianity, and it also explains what is Buddhism. Like, the common sense actually says that, oh, the word religion is not, Buddhism is not the religion of, you know, its definition. Buddhism is not such a religion. Because the word religion, actually, to understand the word religion is to divide. If you can divide the word, if you can divide, you can know, you can understand its meaning. So this word religion, you can divide like re and legion. So re is to do it again, or to do it and repeat. So re is actually meaning is repeat again. And legion is, or liaison, is to connect. So this is a word actually of Christianity, that because human being is creation of God and it was connected, but you know, because of Eve and Adam, you know, it was disattached and human being was destined to get suffering. But it was the religion, the teaching of, you know, Jesus Christ, make people connect with God and people, God. And so this is reconnect is human being and God was disattached. However, the religion, the teaching of Christianity, make people and God connect. So that is original meaning. So if that is a sense, Buddhism is not religion of this kind of definition. However, I understand Buddhism this way. This re is, my understanding is realization. So in Buddhist way of the word religion is realization of connection. Realization of connection is what Buddhism want to tell us, that we are actually all connected still right now in the present moment. We were connected in the past, and we are now currently connected. So what is Buddhism is to realize that we are all connected. Our connection is you and me. And also, not only for that, nature and me, everything and everybody is connected, what we call interdependent. Without nature, we cannot exist. Without you, we cannot exist. We are dependent on each other. So that one, interdependency, is the essence of teaching of Buddhism. So to realize that kind of connection is what Buddhism wanted to tell. So, also this is teaching of Jodo Shu, and this is the essence of Honen Shonin. But what I want to tell, what I want to share is my happiness also, and together to find, to realize the connection. So this is invisible. We cannot see, you know, connection. We, of course, the relationship between parents and child, children, we can see, right? However, you know, you need to realize that whole picture of, you know, interdependency. We need imagination, imagination. And we cannot actually imagine everything. That is, there is a world. This connection is infinity, what we call Amida. So, this lecture, through this, you know, reading of Ichimaki Shomon, I want to provide to realize that connection. So this is my true intention of Ichimaki Shomon. So far, we have reviewed four sentences, and previously we knew that, you know, Sanjin Shishu, that is traditional, very difficult concept of you know, teaching, is actually, we don't need to worry about, you know, Sanjin, or whether we have three minds or not, whether we have three hearts or not. No, we don't need to worry. But through the fact that we recite Namu Amida Butsu, through the fact that we recite Namu Amida Butsu, we can be assured, we can reborn into the pure land of Amida Buddha. And this, through the realization of, you know, Namu Amida Butsu, the expression is very straight. So, Namu Amida Butsu ni te oujo o suru zo to omou uchi ni komori souro nari. So, this is not just to recite Namu Amida Butsu. This is, you know, the recitation of Namu Amida Butsu plus together with the willingness. The willingness is very important. You know, I'm going to be born in the pure land. You know, to confirm the destination, to believe in the destination we are going. And recite Namu Amida Butsu is important. And if we recite Namu Amida Butsu and willingness that I'm reborn into the pure land of Amida Buddha, you can attain. Naturally, you have three minds and four modes of practice. That is Honen Shonin. And this expression is very straight and very powerful, because Namu Amida Butsu nite. So it's not to recite Namu Amida Butsu or to recite Nenbutsu, to chant Nenbutsu, but straight Namu Amida Butsu nite, English, by Namu Amida Butsu. You know, by Namu Amida Butsu, you naturally have three minds and four modes of practice. That is Honen Shonin's straight expression. By the way, the Sanjin is, you know, three kinds of hearts, three kinds of minds, that if we have three kinds of minds, we can attain Ojo. We can be born into the pure land. And this is written in the Meditation Sutra. And recently, I found a very interesting translation. This is Dr. Junjiro Takakusu, about 100 years ago, you know, 80 years ago, he made translation under the direction of Max Müller. So this translation was very interesting, and the Meditation Sutra, the three minds, Sanjin is written, and this is his translation. And Sanjin, what kind of, you know, translation was made by Dr. Junjiro Takakusu? I want to share. So the part three, the meditation. The Buddha then spoke to Ananda and Baidehi, the being who is born in the highest form of the highest grade, are those whoever they may be who wish to be born in that country and cherish the threefold thought whereby they are at once destined to be born there. What is a threefold thought, you may ask? First, the true thought. Second, the deep believing thought. Third, the desire to be born in that pure land by bringing one's own stock of merit to maturity. Those who have the threefold thought in perfection shall mostly assuredly be born into that country. So Dr. Takakusu translated 三人 three kinds of, you know, we are discussing that, is that 三人 or, you know, three hearts or three minds, we are discussing about that. Dr. Takagusu translated 三人 as threefold thoughts is heart. And I think this was very interesting because Raven Hara told me, actually emailed us that, you know, the heart, sorry, kokoro. I always translate heart as kokoro or shin or jin. So the kanji, this kanji, kokoro or shin or jin, this can be translated either mind or heart. In English, mind and heart are two separate things, right? Two individual words. So no relation, completely different. And Raven Hara told me that, you know, in Buddhism, the mind, the heart is mind, the, you know, function of the working is like mindful, and like to believe is actually, in English we understand this is from the mind. To believe is from the mind. This is English way. And so this word soto is more straight, that kokoro is actually meaning thought. So I, you know, Dr. Takakusu translation thought that is deeply based upon that, you know, Buddhist way of to believe is from the thought, from the mind. So, you know, kokoro maybe translate, need to be translated as mind. But I think I want to review Shijoushin, Jinshin, and Eko Hotsuganjin, but one by one, clearly, one more time. But before, you know, talking about Sanjin, we need to know that some words, you know, of Japanese cannot be translated into English exactly. Because Japanese kokoro actually means both mind and heart. Mind and heart, right? So this means that kokoro can be translated either mind or heart. This means that there is no word in English that to express mind and heart together. There is no English word to explain both mind and heart together. So that's why the translation is very difficult. So if that is the case, we can use this word as it is, like kokoro. So because no English word you know, to explain that this has mind, both mind and heart. So that means that you can use Japanese concept as it is. So you can just import and you don't need translation because kokoro means both mind and heart, right? So this is one way. And another way is depending on the context, which is the meaning, which is the meaning you can use. Oh, okay, this is the meaning of mind, this is meaning of the heart. So this is another way. So this is the problem of the translation. For example, there is such a simple word like brother, right? So brother, we know brother. However, actually, there is no Japanese word equivalent of brother, no counterpart of brother, because brother means ani is older brother and ototo is younger brother. And brother actually means both older brother and younger brother, right? However, there is no Japanese that could both mean brother and me. There are older brother and younger brother are actually two completely different words, two different words. So when we hear the word brother, because no word, we have to think, Japanese have to think that is he older brother or is he younger brother? in English culture, which is older and which is younger is actually don't care. It doesn't matter. And if you want to explain in detail, you can say that, you know, by adding like adjective or adverb. So by adding explanation, we can translate everything. But such a simple word, no, there is no word in Japanese. Because this means that English culture or Western culture don't care which is who is older, who is younger. So that's why the brother, the word exists. However, Japanese culture is who is older, who is younger. It's very important. So there must be, you know, two separate words. Older brother is called ani or onii-san, and younger brother is called ototo. Because the culture care which is older and younger are completely different meaning. So this is just like kokoro. Kokoro, you know, we have, and kokoro can be explained if we add some more adjective or adverb, you know, if we add explanation and explanation, but everything can be explained, you know, if we add adjective or adverb. However, the simple word, one word, cannot be translated one word. That is the, you know, the difference of culture. So we have to guess which is which. So if we, you know, hear the word brother, or I have a brother, if somebody said, I have a brother. And if translate Japanese, very hard, because we don't know. But there is a word, I have a brother. 私は兄がいます。私には兄がいます。or 弟がいます。There is no word that could pose. So if that is the case, we can use 私にはブラザーがいます。You can use because there is no concept. Anyway, this is, you know, which is important depending on culture. The translation is difficult or, you know, very. So that is the case. We need to review, examine what is the correct meaning of, you know, 至上心. So 至上心. Is 至上 is genuine or sincere. And there is no doubt that 至上心 means that genuine and sincere. Sincere or genuine. In English, there may be different, but and the shin. So how do we translate shin? Is according to Master Shantou. So Master Shantou actually explained that 至上心とは真実心なり。真実心 is true and true 心ね。Because we don't know 心 is whether mind or heart. We don't know. But I just say true 心。And 至上心とは真実心なり、Master Shantou said. And followed, Master Shantou followed that. 真実心 then what is true 心? True heart, true mind. What is true heart? And Master Shantou said that, 苔の心のなきなり。これは苔の心がないこと。And 苔の心、苔 is like fake mind, fake heart, and vanity. So that one, not true is koke. So what is true 心, ね, true mind, true heart is? Koke の心はない, no fake, and no vanity. And so I think this is where the sincerity comes, where the genuine comes, is I think this is heart. And because, you know, in Western culture, when you indicate yourself, like you point yourself, you point heart, me, myself, point heart. That means the heart is your ID, existence, and, you know, the true heart, the genuine heart, sincere heart. That Master Shantou explained that, you know, 真実心, 至上心とは真実心な true heart. And 苔の心がない。And 苔の心がない is no vanity and no fake heart. So this is, I think, 至上心 is heart. And the next, you know, 人心 and echo of Tsuganji is echo, 人心 Master Shantou explains that 深く信ずる心ない。深く信ずる心。So 信ずる is to believe. To believe deeply. To believe deeply is 人心。So to believe deeply is 人心。So believe, the action of believe is what? Come from mind or come from heart? Is 人心。So coming from mind.Coming from thought. So this is now very clear that what is 人心 and 人心 you know, is literally deep mind or deep heart. We don't know, but 人心 Master Shantou explains that 人心とは深く信ずる心 So 深く and deeply and 信ずる心信ずる信ずる心 is to believeSo that believe, the action of belief is from heart or mind. It's actually mind or thought. So, 人心 is mind, I think is true. And by the way, the word mind and heart, right? Different. And heart is, came from the heart, right? Actual heart. And this heart indicates emotion,or feeling, or the existence, something important, right? And mind, on the other hand, means like memory, or mindful, remind. So this is mind is actually the work of brain. So,The action, the function of brain is actually mind. The functions of emotion is actually heart. So that is kind of difference. So the 人心 is from the mind, from the brain. So 人心 must be deep mind. So actually, 至上心 is heart. So I think, you know, somebody said that, oh, you know, in Buddhist, the mindNo, the 心 should be translated as mind because all the working of belief is from the mind, from the thought, not from the feeling, from the emotion. It's very light. However, if we see, review each word and each explanation, actually, 心 can be both translated into mind and heart.So this is something like the common sense. So 至上心 and 人心 and 恵光発願心 and actually 恵光発願人 sometimes 人 So this one the 漢字心心心 right? So the common sense oh because everything is 心 So everything should be translated if this is mineThis also should be mine, and this also should be mine. And if you think this is heart, then this is should be translated heart and heart, heart, right? So because this one all shin shin shin, so the translation should be if you set the translation as mine, then mine, 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 heart, heart, heart. However,No, this is a common sense. So all the translation. So the Dr. Takakusu, this is translation. Thought. Thought. And thought. So this is, for example, you know, the true thought. The true thought. And next part is the deeply, deep believing thought. Deep believing thought. And the third is,The desire to be born in that pure land by bringing one's own stock of merit to maturity. Oh, so Dr. Takakusu, so this one, desire, instead of thought and mind, he used desire. Desire, which comes from? Is that the mind or heart? So I think desire is also mind. But very interesting that the common sense, we usually translate, if we said mind, heart, you know, thought, but he used desire. That's very interesting. By the way, you know the word desire. Desire means, si is, zaya, it means sidious. It means star. And D means non-star. So the desire, originally word, if you divide two parts, like desire is non-stars. Because you cannot see stars, that you desire, you wish, you want, you know, many stars. That is the meaning of desire. And on the other hand, there is a word, consider. Consider is also same as Zaya. This means Sirius. Is a star. So consider means, come means together. So together, stars. Together stars means that to be mindful of stars, to look many stars, to look many stars, to view stars, is what we call consider. Consider is to think deeply, right? To think deeply. So consider to actually means to think deeply, but it originally means consider is star, looking many stars carefully, precisely. You know, that is the meaning of consider. So anyway, the desire is actually because no star, be careful. So this is a wish. And this wish came from the mind. So anyway, you know, these are actually common sense, right? Common sense. However, if we should translate exactly, exact translation, each time we have to examine the meaning. Each time, if examine the meaning. So the shijoshin, the first, you know, first heart, first shin. What is heart shin? Is shijoshin to a shinjishin nari, and shinjishin to a koke no kokoro no naki o yu. So koke no kokoro ga nai is, so this is heart. So I think shijoshin is not mine. This is heart, sincere heart. That according to the Master Shanto. If you only know the, you know, shijoshin from the characters, if you look at the characters, then it could mean, you know, both sincere mind or genuine mind or sincere heart. We don't know. But this, there is a, you know, explanation by Master Shanta, Kangyo no Shou. Master Shanta will explain that shijoshin is shinjishin. And his understanding, and Master Shanta will understand shijoshin is true mind. True heart. And what is true heart? Shinjishin is koke no kokoro, no fake heart, no vanity. That is shijoshin. So I think the word is heart. Then next, what is jinshin? So again, jinshin, if you know, we only see the characters, we don't know. It means deep mind or deep heart. We don't know. We cannot know. However, Master Shanta will explain that. Jinshin to wa fukaku shinzuru kokoro nari. And this is deep believing. And believing, which comes from, is this brain or from the heart? And believe is not from the emotion or feeling. So that is from the mind. So this is heart, and this is mind. And next part, we can review, you know, Eko Hotsugan Shin or Eko Hotsugan Jin. So I think Dr. Takakusu used the word desire as the shin. So desire to be born in that pure land by bringing one's own stock of merit to maturity. So by using your own merit of, you know, chanting sutras to dedicate, to desire to be born in the pure. So maybe the desire, not desire is, I think, mind or thought, right? But for me, this translation was very more than excellent, because he knew, he examined each word, and he used different words, desire, thought, and thought, right? So this is actually supposed to be the exact translation. So each word, which means this heart, this mind, and this desire or thought. So that was about Sanjin. So anyway, although if we examine each word differently, very complicated and very difficult. However, you don't need to think of Sanjin by straight expression. Namu Amida Butsu nite, by Namu Amida Butsu. No, not by reciting Namu Amida Butsu. Hoden Shonin straightly, straight and strongly said, by Namu Amida Butsu, by Namu Amida Butsu, Namu Amida Butsu nite. 往生するぞ、往生するぞ。This is your strong mind, strong, you know, will that I'm going to be born in the Pure Land. Why? Because I go and then I want to save those who are suffering, those who are poor. That is the, you know, strong will that for others, thinking of others, that he has very strong.Both heart and mind that Honen Shonin had. So reciting, not reciting Namu Amida Butsu, very straight expression again, by Namu Amida Butsu. Namu Amida Butsu にて往生するぞと思ううちに三人 three thoughts, three minds, three hearts, or just we say 三人 all included. You don't need to think of the 三人by this side, but if you think, you believe, deeply believe, if you know your final destination, you are going, you can achieve, you can get, naturally have Sanjin. That is the meaning. So the next part, so Honen Shonin said everything, then Honen Shonin continue. この他に is, you know, other than this. So, because Honen Shonin said everything, truly everything. Okay, that's all he wanted to say. So that means he followed. この他に。Okay, I said everything. Other than this. Okay, other than this. That one, この他に means. 奥深きことを存ぜば、二尊の哀れみに外れ、本願に漏れそうろべし。So, in order to understand this sentence, you need knowledge of all Japanese.Because this sentence doesn't have a subject. This sentence doesn't have a hard subject. But if we know, you know all Japanese, we can know exactly. Although subject is omitted, but subject is actually written. The hint is written. That word is zonze. この他に奥きこと、深きことを存ぜば。この他に奥深きことを存ぜば、and so 存ぜば tells that what is subject in this sentence, and 存ぜば is actually modest expression, humble expression of I. So 存ぜば means subject is I omitted. Like there is a word that 知らぬ存ぜぬ。知らぬ存ぜぬ。And 知らぬ存ぜぬ means I don't know. And 存ぜぬ means modestly said I don't know. So 知らぬ存ぜぬ is a idiom. Not idiot. Idiom. So 知らぬ存ぜぬ is idiom. That I don't know completely. I don't know is 知らぬ存ぜぬ。And 存ぜぬ存 is a humble expression. 存ぜぬ存ぜぬ is humble or modest.Modest expression. So this indicates that 存ぜぬ who, you know, don't know is that I. So other than this, Oden Shoni, if you know, Zon Zeba means I know. If I know, Zeba is provided or if. So if I know, other than this, so Oden Shoni, Zon Zeba is a, you know, the subject is I, Oden Shoni. Oden Shoni, other than this, if I know something deep, something, you know, further, something inside, and この他に、other than this、この他に、奥深きことを存ぜば、奥深き。奥深き is very important、word to understand what is Japanese culture. Like, 奥深き、towards, and 深き means deep.Fukaki means vertically, it's very deep, deep, 深く、深い、奥。And 奥 means inner, the flat place and far inside. So 奥深き means, you know, very deep and very far. So I know, you know,Like the master is the one who knows 奥深きこと. So master is actually known that he knows 奥深きこと. And that means the knowledge, which is deeper knowledge. And the knowledge is far inside. So 奥深き means, 奥深き means like something like everything.Everything. So this is master. Because deep and far. So this cube, right? So this is cube, right? And the beginner, only this part, you know, I know, you know, this part. But the master, what is master is, oku is far inside and deep. So he knows as far as this point. So this means he knows everything. So oku fukaki koto, if I translate oku fukaki koto, that means everything. So Honen Shoni, other than this, if I knowSomething deep, something far inside. Then, what happened? And continue that. この他に、奥深きことを存ぜば、二尊の憐れみに外れ、本願に漏れ候べし。And so, actually, this is a, you know, the subject. If I know everything other than this, if I knowSomething deeper other than this. Then the verb 本願に漏れ候べし。This is the main part of the sentence. The verb 本願に漏れ候べし That meansI cannot receive the benefits of Hongan. I actually don't need it. So later I use subtitle. So Hongan ni more sorobeshi means if.You know, I say I know deeper, you know, other than this. I will not receive Hongan, the benefit of Hongan. That means I don't go to the Pure Land. So this is very scary thing that Honen Shonin bow. Okay, I said everything. This is true. In order to prove that Honen Shonin bow, and if I say I know deeper than other than this, then I don't need to go to the Pure Land. I will not receive Amida Buddha's compassion. That is the meaning. And this is the Hoden Shonin's we call bow or preach. And bow or preach is called kishon. So, Ichimai Kishomon is one sheet document, and document, the Kishomon actually means preach. So this is Honen Shonin's preach or bow, very strong bow that if, you know, I say I know deeper than, you know, something, everything, then I will not receive Amida Buddha's compassion. I will not go to the Pure Land. This is the preach. So that means that, you know, that everything I know, I said everything I know. There is no deep meaning. There is no far inside the teaching. There is no secret part. I showed everything. That is my vow. So, この他に奥深いことを存ぜば、この他に other than this, if I know, you know, something deeper, I will not receive the Amida Buddha's Honga. And before that, there is explanation. If, you know, I know other than this, 二尊の憐れみに外れ。二尊の憐れみ水二尊 What is 二尊? Is 二 is like number, right? 尊 and 尊 is respected. So what is 二尊? Is 二尊 literally means two respected people, two respected saints.And who is to respect it? And actually, Nisan is actually common noun. So it doesn't say specific name. So, for example, if you look up into the dictionary, Nisan is Izanabi or Izanagi.So Nisan, in this case, Izanami and Izanagi is actually Japanese god, the origins of god. So this is god and goddess. This is goddess and this is god. So Nisan, because Nisan is a word, common noun, so Nisan means, you know, to respect it. And who is to respect it? That Izanami and Izanagi. And another Nisan, so,Jodo Shuwe is Nisan is Amida and Shakyamuni. So this is Nisan is Amida and Shakyamuni. That is Jodo Shu understanding of Nisan. And there is a word also Sanzon. So Sanzon is three.And zon is actually son. So the kanji son is, so this is san zon. And nison is nison. So nison san zon is a word. So san is three respected saints. So in Jodo Shu, so san zon is also common noun. San zon is also common noun. So san zon, who is three saints?And depending on which, you know, denomination, which school, they are different. Like Amida Sanzon, we call Amida Sanzon. Amida Sanzon is Amida. So Jodo Shu way of Sanzon is Amida, Buddha, and Kannon Bodhisattva, and Seishi Bodhisattva.So that one, 1, 2, 3. Amida and Kannon and Seishi. And Kannon Seishi is called Hidari Kannon Migi Seishi. Hidari Kannon Migi Seishi. So Amida Buddha is center and Hidari Kannon Migi Seishi. And so you face to Amida Buddha, the right side, which is Amida Buddha's left side, is Kwannon Bodhisattva. And facing the Amida Buddha, the left side, which is Amida Buddha's right side, is Seishi Bodhisattva. So these Bodhisattva and Amida Buddha we call Sanzon, three respected saints. And Kannon is actually the compassion. And Seishi is Bodhisattva of wisdom. So compassion and wisdom is actually the function of Amida Buddha. Amida Buddha is a Buddha of compassion, endless compassion and endless wisdom, infinite wisdom. So this is we call it Sanzon. And on the other hand, Sotoshu or you know other schools like Shaka Sanzon. So when we indicate Shaka Sanzon.
Shaka Sanzon, and which depending on which school, the Sanzon is can be proper noun, but otherwise Sanzon is common noun, and Sanzon Shaka Sanzon is Shakyamuni Buddha, and Monju Bodhisattva, and Fugen Bodhisattva. So Shakyamuni Buddha and Monju Bodhisattva and Fugen Bodhisattva. And Monju Bodhisattva is also wisdom. And Fugen Bodhisattva is compassion. So three Sanzon is according to Shakyamuni Buddha, Sanzon means Monju and Fugen. And another Sanzon, like Yakushi Bodhisattva has also Sanzon, the medicine Buddha. The medicine Buddha has Nikko Bosatsu and Gekko Bosatsu. It's sunlight and moonlight Bodhisattva. So that one also both means compassion and wisdom. So Sanzon is actually common noun, and depending on which Buddhist denomination, Sanzon means different. And Jodoshu, there is a word, Sanzon Rai, that Master Shantou's Ojo Rai-san. So Sanzon Rai is Amida Buddha, Kannon Bodhisattva, which is left side of Amida Buddha, and Seishi Bodhisattva. This one we call Sanzon. But this case, Nison is two saints, two respected saints is Amida Buddha and Shakyamuni Buddha. So Amida Buddha and Shakyamuni Buddha. So Nison no awaremi ni hazure. And awaremi ni means compassion or pity. So Nison no awaremi is two saints, Amida Buddha and Shakyamuni Buddha's pity, awaremi. Is pity or compassion or mercy. So that is the meaning of awaremi. So, okay, I don't receive, if I say I know something deeper than this, Nison no awaremi hazure. Hazure means excluded. So, this is something like, I might exclude it from compassion of two saints, Amida Buddha and Shakyamuni Buddha. So, I'm excluded from the compassion of Shakyamuni Buddha and Amida Buddha. And the next part is, Hongan ni more sorou beshi. 本願に漏れ候べし is I will not receive, you know, the attaining of Ojo. That is the whole nation is very strong wish. So, この他に奥深きことを存ぜば、in other words, I think if I can simply translate this, if I'm telling a lie, so this is something like that. If I'm telling a lie, in case I'm telling a lie, 二尊の憐れみに外れ、I will not, you know, receive the compassion of Amida Buddha and Shakyamuni Buddha. So, if I'm telling lie to you, because I said everything, is this, so you might think, oh, is that sure, Master? Are you sure that, is that everything? You don't hide anything. And Honen Shonin was very kind, and Honen Shonin was thinking already that possible students doubt, you know, the disciples doubt, and his kindness and his thoughtfulness made this Kishomon that, okay, you might have doubt, but if I'm telling lie, that is the expression. この他に奥深きことを存ぜば。Other than this, I say I know everything. That means, if I'm telling lie to you, if I'm lying to you, and 二尊の憐れみに外れ is, I will not receive the compassion of Amida Buddha and Shakyamuni Buddha. And 本願に漏れ候べし。本願に漏れ候べし。And 本願。本 is like basic. And 願 is like wish or desire. So this is something like that thought.And the basic. And original word is Purva Pradani, Pradani. Pranidani, Pranidana. Purva Pranidana. So Purva Pranidana is the Sanskrit word of Honga. Purva Pranidana. Purva Pranidana.Purva is in front. So before and Pranidana. In front of Pranidana is a wish. And Hon is that also like Moto is like cause.And because, you know, 何でしたかね、ダマカヤ、ダマカヤ、法蔵菩薩、法蔵菩薩、法蔵菩薩 made vows, 48 vows. And this vow caused him to become Buddha. So, 本願 is, ダマカヤ's, you know, 48 vows caused him.To be Buddha. So this is Hon Gan, is Purva Pranidana. Purva Pranidana is Hon, is a cause. At the same time, is essence. Basic, very basic. That is Hon Gan is actually translated usually original verb. But if we examine Hon, what is Hon Gan? Purva Pranidana is verb. Oh, this is verb. Wish. Sorry. It was a long talk, so the, you know, media file, the SD card was full, full capacity. So anyway, the Hon Gan is Purva Pranidana. Purva Pranidana. Purva Pranidana is the essence.Bow, the original, and that bow caused Amida Buddha, the Bodhisattva, the Hozo Bodhisattva, Dhammakaya, to be Amida Buddha. So this is Hon Gan. And what is Honga is Zara 48. And this is, you know, the very strong that, you know, those who call his name, Amida Buddha, is surely born into the pure land of Amida Buddha. So that Amida Buddha's vow was achieved because Amida Buddha became Amida Buddha, Buddha. So this is Honen Shonin. If I'm telling a lie to you, I will not receive Honga. I will not go. That means Honga ni more soro be. So more soro be soro you can ignore. This is polite expression. So more beshi is surely it will, it has to, you know, excluded from the original verb. It more actually means leak or you cannot gain or excluded. So you may be excluded from the original vow of Amida Buddha. That is the meaning of Honga ni more soro beshi. And Nison no awaremi ni hazure. Hazure means also excluded. Awaremi ni hazure means you are excluded. So excluded from the, you know, Nisons to respect the saints of Amida Buddha and Shakyamuni Buddha's compassion. That means you don't receive Amida Buddha's compassion and Shakyamuni Buddha's compassion. And Hongan ni more soro beshi. And Hongan, this case is that Hongan is actually also come on now. It could mean somebody's vow, but according to Jodo-shu or Jodo Pure Land Buddhism, the Hongan indicates that Dhammakaya, the specific noun, the proper noun, that Amida Buddha's, Dhammakaya's vow, original vow. And there is a similar word that Seigan, like Hotoke no Seigan, Bodhisattva Seigan, Shigu Seigan, the four Bodhisattva's vows. That is, we call Seigan. And Seigan means, to preach, and Gan is bar or desire. So desire and preach. So both meaning same. And but Hongan is that already caused, it caused, the bar caused him to be Amida Buddha. So that's why we call Amida Buddha's bow, the Dhammakaya's bow is called Honga. So Nison no awaremi ni hazure means I don't receive Amida Buddha's compassion and Shakyamuni Buddha's compassion, and I will not born into the pure land. Honga ni more soro beshi is you are excluded, you are out, you are out from, you know, Dhammakaya's original vow. That is Honen Shonin, the strongest preach, strongest vow. Okay, I didn't hide anything. I showed everything. I said everything. And this is Honen Shonin's thoughtfulness, because after maybe Honen Shonin imagined that, this is Honen Shonin's imagination. Honen Shonin passed away because Honen Shonin's teaching is very straight and very clear, but very easy to everybody understand, very simple. So some student might think that, oh, I secretly receive Honen Shonin's essence of teaching. I know essence of teaching, you know, secretly. I know oku fukaki koto, like something deeper. I know deeper meaning of Nenbutsu. And the disciple might, you know, show the superiority of others. This is like competition. And student, if we have many students, each student may be very special. And each student may be, you know, insist, I'm superior than others because I know the secret. I know the deep meaning. So Honen Shonin imagine that kind of situation. So I said truly everything. And other than this, I don't say any deeper thing. I'm not telling lie. So that is Honen Shonin's preach, that I'm not saying anything deeper than this. And this means that, you know, Namu Amida Butsu ni te, Ojo suru zo to omou uchi ni komori soro nari. is that, you know, Sanjin and three Shishu, the principal teaching is all included that by Namu Amida. And the willing that I will be born into the Pure Land. That was all included. So this is what we call Kishomon is written that Honen Shonin's strong power, the strong preach that I'm not hiding anything. So this is the greatness of Honen Shonin. And this is just like Shakyamuni Buddha. Shakyamuni Buddha was enlightened and he didn't hide any teaching. You know, he was very generous, saying, preaching, you know, to all people he met. He didn't hide. He didn't hide any special deep, you know, things that he opened everything. That is the greatness of Shakyamuni Buddha. And Honen Shonin was exactly like that. The greatness. He didn't hide any secret teaching. You know, he said everything. That is the Honen Shonin's Ichimai Kishomon. So, thank you very much for listening to this. So, この他に奥深きことを存ぜば。So, because there is no subject, you know, people might misunderstand that, you know, this is telling about student, okay, student. If you know deeper than this, you will be, you know, excluded from original Bhava Amida Buddha. You are out of, you know, Amida Buddha's compassion. You are out of Amida Buddha, Shakyamuni Buddha's compassion. So that's not true. That is the Dzongzen is a word that Honen Shonin's modest way, humble expression that この他に奥深くことを存じれば If I know other than this, you know, that means my interpretation is If I'm telling lie, I will not receive Amida Buddha's compassion. I will not receive Shakyamuni Buddha's compassion. And I will not be born into the pure land of Amida Buddha. That is Honen Shonin's strong will. So I truly appreciate that Honen Shonin showed everything, such a simple sentence. And last, you know, there was a scholar priest called Gizan Shonin in the 17th to 18th century, in the end of 17th century. The Gizan Shonin said that Honen Shonin's teaching is, if you enlarge it, it becomes senchakushu. And if you shrink the senchakushu, if you make smaller the senchakushu, it becomes Ichimai Kishomon. So that is what Gizan Shonin said. And yet Gizan Shonin explains that nothing important was cut in the Ichimai Kishomon. Although, you know, the Ichimai Kishomon is shrink version of the smaller version, tiny version of Senchakushu. However, nothing important is cut. So I imagine that what Gizan Shonin said is something like this. Ichimai Kishomon is this fan, like fan. If you enlarge it, if you open it, it becomes Senchakushu. But Hirogereba Senchakushu, Subomereba, if you shrink it, it becomes Ichimai Kishomon, one sheet document. Yet, nothing cut, but it was just folded. And excellently, it was shrink. The essence is here in the Ichimai Kishomon. So, thank you very much for listening to this. And next part, I don't know when I can deliver, but thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you.